Thank you, Lord. God, we want to see it, God. We want to see it, God. We want to see your kingdom come here, God. We want to see and experience heaven. Touch earth, God. Father, we thank you that you're holy, God. And Father, we can say holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty God. Father, we thank you, God, that we can, God, come into your presence, God, because of the blood, God. Father, we can, God, experience, God, being in your presence, God, where you're trained, God, will fill our temple, God. We say thank you, God. Father, we thank you that you're mighty. We thank you that you're awesome. We thank you that you're faithful, God. Father, we thank you that you're amazing, God. God, we adore you right now, God. God, we lift up the name of Jesus right now, God. God, we see him high and lifted up above all things, God. We see him now, God, as our Savior, God. Our King, our Redeemer right now. High and lifted up, God. Father, we lift him right now, God. Father, we lift him right now in our minds. We lift him in our hearts, God. We lift him in our situations right now, God. We lift him, God. God, because you have gave him a name that is high above all names, God. Father, we thank you, God. For the Messiah, we thank you, God, for the anointed one, God. Yes, God, his name is sweet, God. In his name, there's refuge, God, and safety, God. In his name, there's strength and peace, God. Yes, God, is in his name, God. Yes, yes, God. It's in his name, God. It's in his name. It's in his name, God. Ah, Shaitan, it's in his name, God. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus. Yes, yes. Yes, Jesus. Call his name. Call all over the building. Thank you. you, Lord. Mighty you are, God. Mighty you are, mighty you are, mighty you are. Mighty you are. Lord, you're mighty. If you can't say nothing else, say, Lord, you're mighty. 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 All over the building, Lord, you're mighty. Yes, 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 I feel that one. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Yes, yes. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Yes, God, Lord, you're mighty. Father, we thank you, God. Father, we thank you that you're mighty and you know you're mighty, God. Father, we thank you right now, God, for your word, God. Father, your word is forever settled in heaven, God. Father, we just say thank you, God. God, you said, God, that you sent your word to heal us and to deliver us, God, from our distresses, God. So, Father, we thank you in advance, God, for what your word is about to do, God. Father, you said that your word will not return to your void, God, but it will do that thing, God. It will accomplish it, God. So, Father, I decree and declare, God, today, God, today, today, God, that your anointing, God, will destroy yokes, God, and will remove burdens today in the name of Jesus, God. Father, I decree and declare, God, that your anointing, God, will bring forth light, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Father, I decree and declare, God, that your anointing, God, will set captives free this day in the name of Jesus, God. I decree and declare, God, that your anointing, God, will dismantle depression and discouragement, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Your anointing, God, whatever it is, God, that's not of you, God, your anointing, God, will dismantle it today, God, in the name of Jesus. It will dismantle doubt and fear, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Father, we come today, God, to take authority, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Father, we thank you for this atmosphere right now, God. The devil even know, God, that you're finna do a great work, God. The devil know, God. You done let the devil know, mm-hmm, that your word coming to pass. Yeah, 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 yeah. The devil know that you're about to receive your promise. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You may not know it, but the devil know that you're about to receive your promise, because he sees the pain that you're in. And the pain is a sign of your deliverance. Lord, have mercy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're about to receive the manifestation. Yeah, yeah. And I hear God saying right now, the curtains are open. Lord, have mercy. The curtains are open. It's manifestation time. Tell somebody that it's manifestation time. Yeah, yeah. That thing that I've been waiting on is coming to pass. Yeah, yeah. I almost gave up, but it's coming to pass. Lord, have mercy. I almost lost my mind. Lord, have mercy. But it's coming to pass. Yeah, yeah. My promise, even with my eyes closed, Lord, have mercy. I could be a blind man and I can sense my promise walking up on me. You ought to be able to close your eyes and say, I sense my promise walking up on me. You know, sometimes Roy Civic could be in the house and I can just feel her around me. I feel my promise. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I feel my promise right now. I don't know about you, but if you got a promise that you've been waiting on, you ought to feel your promise. Yeah, talk to your promise and say, promise, come here. Yeah, yeah. Promise, come to me. Yeah, yeah. He said you can call those things as be not as though they were. Call your promise. Say, promise here. Fall in order. Lord have mercy. See, Roy, I wasn't in the army long, but I know what it means to fall in order. That means come right here. Yeah, yeah. You got to get in place, promise. Yeah. I see you've been tarrying for a while, but now delayed season is over. It's time. No, good God. It's time for the manifestation. Yeah. It's time for your manifestation. Yeah. You need to open your mouth and say, it's manifestation time. Yeah, yeah, it's manifestation time. It's manifestation time. Yeah, yeah, it's manifestation time. Yes, yes, God. Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. God, we thank you for preaching grace right now, God. God, we thank you for your word of wisdom and word of knowledge, even right now, God. We thank you for prophetic utterance, God. God, you said in your word, God, and we're putting you in remembrance of your word right now. God, you said you wouldn't do nothing without revealing it first to your servants, the prophets. Father, we thank you. Father, pour grace upon my lips. Help me to speak with clarity and with conviction, God. Use me, God, with great grace and with great power. Father, cause your face to shine upon my countenance. Father, I decrease that you may speak to me and through me. Show yourself strong and mighty. Father, that we don't have no choice but to give you praise, honor, and glory. And it's in Jesus' name. Let us all say amen. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Am I the only one in here that can tell him thank you without music? Thank you, Lord. Could have been dead, sleeping in my grave, but thank you, Lord. Not only could have been, but should have been, deserved to be. So I got to tell him thank you. Yeah. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty. Mighty you are. Your mercy endureth forever. Anybody in here ever received the Lord's mercy? Anybody here know that he's a merciful God? Is there anybody in here that know that early this morning, before you woke up, he had already given you new mercies? New mercies. We do thank God for you today. We do thank God for you pressing your way to the sanctuary. Press your way to the sanctuary. It wasn't easy for everybody to get here. If I need to, I get my buddy to make y'all talk to y'all neighbor, but it wasn't so easy for everybody to make it today. Amen. He had to give some of us a boost. Amen, because we had excuse on our mind. Amen. Y'all don't want to tell the truth. We ain't gonna check nothing off, but all of us have the ability to make an excuse. Amen. See, Roy, that's close right there. You know, Sister Collette, when you think about not just going today, see, they think that's just for the congregation. I could do it too. Amen. Siv, you sleepy? Me too. But sometimes you got to press. Because he pressed for us. Yeah, he pressed. Yeah. The Lord don't make excuses. Y'all know that? God don't make excuses. Genesis, the 40. Go to the 41st chapter. Amen. His grace is sufficient. He say he's able to make all grace abound to every good work. Amen, amen. The Lord knows where you are right now. Genesis, the 41st chapter, and the first verse. I feel some of you right now personally. What I mean by that, I can feel your heaviness by name. Mm-hmm. Do you know that you can get dressed and come to church heavy? You can even put your makeup on, hide it, and still be heavy. Yeah, I feel some of you, right? Now, it wouldn't take much for you to explode. Wouldn't take much for you to break down. But guess what? He got a word for you. Yeah, he got... I'm not really concerned about your neighbor, but right now, he has a word for you. Mm-hmm. I shared with my wife this morning, all glory to God, it was approximately 2 a.m. We were in Miami changing a tire. Yeah, and Siva said to me this morning, she said, "Terriss, you got out like it wasn't no problem." I say, "What is God up to?" We didn't have a flat tire, but the tire began to wobble. And I said, "Siva, what I'm going to go ahead and do is, because I know you got to drive, I'm going to go ahead and just change it." Mm-hmm. And Sister Colette, we pulled over and got to the hotel, and Brother Tory, I jacked the car up. Mm-hmm. And my wife, I said, "Y'all sit on in the car and run the air." And she came out and she was trying to help me. Somebody say trying to help me. And I'm up under the car laying down, and she goes and get her sweater and lays it down on the ground for me. Mm-hmm. And she gets her phone and she tries to shine it down to the bottom so I can see a little bit better, Brother Tory. And I'm changing the tire, the left front tire on the driver's side, and I want the air on the car, so I'm feeling that heat and I'm sweating, but I'm trying to change this tire. And Sister Colette, I change the tire and I go back there and get the spare. Tory put it on. There's a gas station. Y'all watch this. I used this word one time this week. That was adjacent to the hotel. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Uh-huh. Yeah. That sounds better than rags, don't it? And so I put the tire on, the vehicle, and rolled to the hotel, to the gas station. And by that time, it had broke its seal. And I couldn't put air in the tire to blow it up. And we called AAA, and what AAA told us, I said, I might as well put the same tire back on. Mm-hmm. And so after I put the same tire back on, I say, "Civet, bring me our oil." We saw wires coming out the tire. Y'all ain't hearing me. And I said, "Lord, keep this tire all the way back, not just to our house, but to church and to the tire place." Mm-hmm. I know how it sounds. I know it sounds crazy. And Tory, I rub that tire with anointed oil like you rub a baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I put it back on, Brother Gamble, and I expected, Lord have mercy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I expected to make it home, Lord have mercy. And as I was driving, Roy, this morning, I took off driving. I had a good feeling this morning. Yeah, yeah. Had one text on the way. Yeah, yeah, yes. Early this morning, Sister Leonard texted and talking about, "I hope you ain't wearing Sylvia out." I didn't text you back then because I was driving. But let me tell you what the Lord said to me. Some of us pray for some stuff and don't believe God to do it. I was going down the road, Tory, about this is about 5:30, 6 o'clock. Got me a little cat nap after studying. Yeah. About 30, 45 minutes. And going down the road, I was doing about 50 or 60 on 95. You know that looked crazy. And the Lord say, are you going to drive? Y'all. And Sylvia saw me hit it. Yeah. Wasn't nothing wrong with the tire no more. Not in my mind, because I heard the Lord. Because when he asked me, was I going to drive, he was telling me, you're going to make it home. Mm-hmm. And so when we, yeah, good God Almighty. And so as we was going home, I say, Sylvia, where in the world is 60? Because I've been driving a long time. I said, I'm telling you, when we get to 60, I'm through driving. And I'm going to fix my nose up for service. And so when she got over there, she had maybe, how long you drove today so you could tell the church? I pushed that thing today. Y'all give the Lord. Yeah. I said, Sylvia, now you got to drive like I was driving. She said, no, I'm going to do 7. I ain't going over around 75 and 80. And we made it here on time. I just give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Because, Brother Errol, we saw wires this morning. We serve a faithful God. And I didn't come to talk to you about a tire, but I did come to talk to you about, if I could use for a title, behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, behind the scenes. Most movies, I got all these notes and I don't even know if I'm going to be able to get to them. Most movies that come to the red box, or they got a fire stick or something out here, right? Fire stick or YouTube or AMC. We don't usually get to see what goes on behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. We get to see the finished work. Mm-hmm. The producer, Roy. Oh, have mercy. Man, y'all better give the Lord a hand clap of praise for Brother Ray. Yeah. The producer, what I've learned is he doesn't start making his movie from the beginning and work to the end. He knows his whole movie. So he starts at the end and works back to the beginning. Lord have mercy. And so here do I read. In Genesis 41, there's a man by the name of Joseph. Somebody say Joseph. Joseph's name means the Lord shall add to. Amen. Joseph, mm-hmm. His dad's name was Jacob. Amen. And Jacob had several other boys. And Joseph had a, this is not in this chapter, this is in 37, had a coat. Somebody say a coat. His coat was different from the rest of the brothers, so they can recognize the favor. Lord have mercy. And if God's favor is on you, people around you should be able to recognize that the favor of God is on you. Not only that, if God's blessing is on you, people ought to be able to recognize if God is blessing you or not. Lord have mercy. Don't just tell me you're blessed. There ought to be some signs. There ought to be some evidence that you're blessed. Lord have mercy. I ain't talking about your car. I ain't talking about your house. But you ought to even just have a sound mind should show me that you're blessed. Lord have mercy. You just saying thank you, Jesus, tell me you blessed. You getting up and able to wave your hands is enough to say that you're blessed. So here is this young boy by the name of Joseph. And Joseph has a dream, Lord have mercy. And a dream is nothing but a word that comes while you sleep in seed form. Good God. And here, brother, what I learned, Roy, that a word, a seed must die, Lord have mercy, before it comes to pass. Good God. So that seed has to go under the ground, Lord have mercy. So the promises that you're waiting on got to go down before they come up. Here in the text, God downloads, Yahiyahroy, downloads a dream in Joseph. And when he downloads this dream, Joseph messed around and get up. Good God. Have you ever heard God give you something while you're laying down that make you want to stand up? Lord have mercy. See, some of us need somebody to shake us up. But if God say the right thing while you're laying down, you don't need, good God, you don't need nobody to wake you up, because that thing he spoke to you in the late night hour, it'll make you get up and say late in the midnight hour, God gonna turn it around. You might not have no piano player, but he's gonna turn it around. He might not just turn it around one time, but there's some stuff that you might need him to turn around again and again and again, because there's some stuff, Lord have mercy, that we've been dealing with a long, good God, a long time. And God has said to us that he that had begun a good work, will perform it. That means what God has said to you is coming to pass. But you stuck in the middle, Lord have mercy. Say, I've been stuck in the middle, believing and waiting on a dream. So here is Joseph, got this dream, and he gets up and opened his mouth. Woo! Lord have mercy, Tori. See, sometimes you got to be quiet as long as you can. Y'all better catch that. Because there's some stuff that God say to you, you can't hold. Mm-hmm. Yeah, y'all ain't gonna freeze me in here. I promise you that. There's some stuff that God has said to me that I be waiting for Sibby to roll over. And if she don't roll over fast enough, I help roll over Sibby, and she'll do it too. Terriss, let me tell you what I had a dream. And I'm over there trying to go back to sleep. And now, Terriss, do you hear me? What she said, God has said something to me that the whole house need to get up right now. Have God ever made you a promise to make you wake up your whole house? Yeah. And we get in there, we're not worrying about the children. I don't care what time they went to bed. We're talking about a promise now. Yeah, a promise will make you get excited at 1 in the morning, 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning. Because when those promises come, they come when things are dark. And so Joseph releases this dream to his brothers. If I ought to be able to share my dream anywhere, I should be able to tell my brothers. But let me go ahead and talk to you about your brothers and your sisters, your homegirls and your homies. Some of them can't handle your dreams, and definitely can't handle when you start telling them to them. And so Joseph tells his dreams. They already don't like him. We almost. You use a word called bipolar. I ain't speaking to nobody, but sometimes we get crazy. We think everybody gonna shout when you tell them what God said to you. No, some of them gonna fall out. Not on the ground, fall out with you because of what God told you. You don't believe me? Let me talk to you about your brothers. And so Joseph tells his brothers, they already got a problem about this favor, and now he tells them the dreams, and in Genesis 37, they hate him more, not only for the dream, but for his words. If you keep on saying what you're waiting on, what God to do for you, there are going to be some people you ought to expect to fall out, because they don't expect God giving you that, what you're decreeing and what you're declaring out of your mouth. But we get to the point that I don't want to say it because I don't want to lose no friend. The devil is a liar. I got a friend that stick it closer than the boy, if you would have fell out when I was in jail, that's all right. But I had to believe God to get me out. And some of us are so caught up and tied to friends that we're scared to tell them. No, yes, I'm going to tell you. I'm believing God to do great and mighty things. I'm believing God to do exceeding, good God, abundantly above all that I may ask or think. When are you going to do it? I'm expecting it suddenly. Yeah. I don't come to Beesville to play. No. We play home. We could have been watching ESPN, what they call it? football on Sunday at noon. Y'all know what I'm talking about. They don't got it now where it used to be at 12 and 1. They got it at 11. You better catch what I'm trying to tell you. They'll make it where you can miss TV, miss church. I remember when I was a child. At a certain time at night, all, you know, everybody had rabbit ears. Back. You don't know what rabbit ears do. We had cable boxes on the side of the house. And when you ain't had rabbit ears, you had a clothes hanger that you stick down in the antenna. And if you move that joker right, you get a signal and you can watch V32. They couldn't cut that off. That came with the TV. All your mama need to have is a hanger in the house. Y'all see, Trinity said, that boy in a strange tongue right now. It wasn't no remote with that. It was roll it. You ain't rolling all day. You ain't had but a few channels. So if you click it, click it, click it, click it, and it don't turn, that means move the antenna. And then the mama get a big check. She go to the store and buy her some rabbit ears for about $12.99. And she placed them rabbit ears on. See, I done saw the rabbit ears. The black and white TVs. That joke was so small, you almost could. It wasn't no big screen back then. And everybody had to sit still to watch that little screen. Be fizzing and all that. Static. And now we're talking about, look how clear my TV show. Back then, boy, you be looking to see the booger man back there. I'm trying to see who playing. Is that the Cowboys and the Bucks? Are they all on one TV? Who is that? It wasn't no color now. I'm trying to. It wasn't no color. Tori, you young too. You ain't see that, did you? He saw it. And so here, Joseph tells his dreams, and his dreams get him in a little trouble to the point that now his brothers see him coming, and they say, behold, here comes the dreamer. And they get together. If God has given you the gift of dreams, you ought to bless God for that. Amen. Amen. You ought to thank God for it. But with that gift, you ought to ask God to give you the gift of interpretation. Amen. Because you need to know what God is saying without going to Walmart and buying a dream book. Because if he give you the dream, he know what he's saying. Don't come up here and tell me about no dream book. I don't want to hear it. If this ain't your dream book, y'all can say the pastor rule. No, I don't want to hear it. So if you got a dream book at the house, you need to get rid of it. Mm-hmm. That ain't God. Anytime you seeking wisdom outside of God for something he trying to tell you, that's not God. I know somebody got a dream book in here. And so what happens, they stand by these brothers and say, let's get rid of him. Watch this. And see what becomes of his dreams. They were saying is, we're going to get rid of him and see if we can change what he said out of his mouth. Good God. There are some people that are bothering you just to see if you'll start saying something different than what you've been saying. Lord have mercy. Yeah, there are some people, that are strategically placed in your life. Yeah, yeah. And God is allowing it to see if you really believe what he said to you. Lord have mercy. And God don't always start in the streets or in the jar. Sometimes they're real close to you and kin to you. And you got to believe God in your own house before you go stand on top of the house. Lord have mercy. Don't come down here to the church telling me what God said and you're not willing to walk around your own house and post your own dream. We ain't finna have all that stuff posted on your wall. Go post it on your own wall. Do you believe God in your own house? It don't take all that. Yes, it do. Yes, it do. Yes, I'm going to prove it to you. And then we're going to get in that car with that wobbly tire and go home. And I'm going to go find somewhere to get us a tire today. After we eat. Man, shoot. Boy, I sweat it like that 2 o'clock in the morning, you know I'm hungry. in all the stores and buy him. And you know what them jokers tell you? We want to pay for that. No ice. No ice. Ice done. How ice done? That's water. Machine. Joker look at me like, ice done. Didn't get no ice. I guess the hurricane affected them. They ain't giving no ice down there on 167. None of the stores. Ice done. Both stores said the same thing. Both of them was Haitians, too. I don't know if you want ice, but ice done up in here. And so this is what happened to Joseph. So we can hurry and go. Joseph, brothers try to get rid of him because of what God has given to Joseph. And they sell Joseph. And once they sell Joseph, you can see in Genesis 39 that as he went down in verse 1 and 2, it continued to say that the Lord was with him. This is what that showed me, Roy. No matter what people do to you, they should be able to see that the Lord is still with me. If you're in the projects, the people in the projects ought to know that the Lord is with you. If you're in prison, the people ought to know that the Lord is with you. If you done got laid off your job, the people on your job ought to be able to say, we laid him off, but it looks like the Lord is still with him. And so here, Joseph, he finds himself in a different place, and he's in Potiphar's house, and he's usually walking with his buddy. Somebody say amen. But Joseph was a good-looking dude. Somebody say good-looking. And Joseph messed around and let his guard down. And when he let his guard down, Potiphar went home. And Potiphar, yes, he's somewhere tending to Pharaoh's business. You better listen to this. And while he's tending to Pharaoh's business, he done left his wife home too long with a good-looking Joseph. Yeah. And she see Joseph walking around the house healthy, and I know y'all done saw it on TV, and Potiphar come home with this long old dress looking all crazy, but Joseph ain't looking like that. Y'all better catch that now. You can work around somebody's house all day if you want to and leave the lawn man there all day. See, we want to get all crazy. You leave that joke out there with all the muscles and you are gone for 2 and 3 weeks at a time. He was getting water and bringing his own. Now he getting ice on the porch. And then Potiphar come home in his yard looking all good. And he got an address and his wife got an address, but he tired. Go ahead, be tired. Honey, do you need Joseph to cut any trees tomorrow? Get a hold of Joseph while you're going over to Pharaoh's. How long you going to be over to Pharaoh's? Do you want Joseph to paint the barn while you're over to Pharaoh's? And Potiphar ain't got no good God sense. He just think he doing the king a good job. What I'm learning, Sister Leonard, is this. Jesus died for this bride. I met my bride 1919, West 10th Street, number 59. Y'all ain't catch that. And if I'm out there washing cars, Lord have mercy, and she start talking that come home talk, Brother Aaron got to wash that next car by himself. Y'all. See, y'all don't want to tell the truth. Yeah. I get on the Parkway. I use his quarters. He got a big jar in the back seat with quarters. Let me get the wrong text or the wrong call. Let me hear him say, y'all can go. And so what happens, this is what y'all need to see. People will lie on you if you won't give them what they want. I ain't just talking about that kind of stuff. But let it be somebody that wants something from you and you have it and you don't give it to them even after they're persistent asking you, they'll lie on you. Mm-hmm. And so what happens, she lies on Joseph. Now remember, God done gave Joseph a promise, and I promise you, we're finna go home. God done gave Joseph a promise. Now Joseph is in prison because of this woman lied on him. Mm-hmm. I can imagine Joseph was looking for the promise to come to pass in prison. Good God. And see, some of us think our promise is going to come to pass up in here. Lord have mercy. But God had to allow Joseph to get to a place called a dungeon. Do you know what a dungeon is? A dungeon is a underground, Lord have mercy, prison. There go that seed. That promise had to go underground. But while he's in the dungeon, there's a butler and a baker there, Lord have mercy. And Joseph still having these dreams in prison. So I don't care what you're in right now, God is still going to deal with you, Lord have mercy. Because he's sovereign. Your situation don't stop God from using you because his grace is sufficient. It ain't your gift, it's the gift of God, Lord have mercy. So here Joseph is in prison and he comes to jail, Lord have mercy. And instead of him getting mad and not using his gift, two of them wake up in the morning and they're looking soggy by the face. Y'all know how y'all be looking in praise and worship sometimes. Look like you done drunk prunes at the church down the street. And Joseph say, why you looking so sad? And they tell him his dreams. And Joseph say, the Lord wants to give you an interpretation. Now I got to stop right here for a minute because you're not going to like every dream interpretation. Now one of them sit back and watch the pastor, Lord, good God, prophesy to this one. And watch him prophesy to that one. And then you get up and testify and say, God did just what you said. Now they sitting over there wondering, if I go in the line, is God going to tell me something good? Well, you might better go over there and talk to the butler. Because if you ain't getting restoration, ain't no need for the pastor to tell you restoration. Because some of them might be getting hung because they didn't set some things in order. And so what happens, one of them get restored to a good place. And Joseph tells him, remember me. Yeah, y'all going to have to read your own Bible, just Genesis 37 through 41. And what happens in Genesis 41, after verse 14 in chapter 40, this man done got restored. Have you ever been a blessing to somebody and they forgot about you? Y'all, if they ain't beside you, go ahead and say amen. Have you ever helped somebody do better? And then when they get, how we say it, when they get up on their feet, now they acting all good at two-shoe. And they act like they don't know us no more. They act like they don't remember us no more. Uh-huh. And let me talk to you about the sovereignty of God. God sometimes won't allow people to remember you. Mm-hmm. And so God allows Pharaoh, somebody say Pharaoh, to have a dream. And around Pharaoh, yeah, we're about to close, he had some magicians, and they could not interpretate the dream. Yeah, here y'all go, right here. Sister Collette, sometimes God will allow people to be in places, yeah, and I don't know how they may have got these positions, but it's going to come to a place, Lord have mercy, this for sanctuary. It's going to come to a place, Sister Constance, when they can't do the things that they said they can do. Yeah. And then their boss is going to say, I thought you put on your resume that you were trained to do such and such. And then there's going to be somebody, yeah, that you may have touched their life, yeah, good God, over at Food Line, and I know they closed, yeah. A long time ago, you don't forget about Food Line, you don't forget about Zares, you don't forget about Ames, you don't forget about TGNY, but there was somebody that you touched in the store, Lord have mercy, and they're gonna be around their boss and they're gonna say, I'm a member, yeah, I remember this young lady, I remember this young man that prayed for me and say, Father, I stretch, good God, my hand to thee, God, I pray for their son, I pray for their child, God, I speak deliverance to their whole house, and they're gonna say, I'm a member, and I know, good God, they got a gift, but guess what? They're in a dungeon. Oh, good God. Now, let me talk to you about this dungeon. Your promise has to go through a dark place. And your promise needs somebody to carry it. Mm-hmm. You know how women get married and say they want a baby? Somebody got to carry the baby. I know medical science and all this stuff. They done did a lot of stuff, but they ain't never just had no baby develop without somebody carrying it. Huh. Yeah. And so if God give you a promise, for that promise to be developed, you got to carry it through a dark place. Mm-hmm. Think about a baby. A baby, yeah, they got the, what they call them, the ultrasounds and all that technology. They can peek in at certain times, but it's still dark when they move the light. And so as I was looking at this thing, God began to talk to me about a picture developing. I know you didn't know what I was talking about this morning. And Gamma was talking to me. I said, Gamma, you ever been to a dark room? He said, Brother T, are you talking about those Polaroid one steps? I said, that's it right there. And so let me tell you about this dark room. Anytime, oh, good God, let me tell you about this word develop me. The word develops. Anybody know what I mean? It means to grow or cause to grow. Mm-hmm. To cause to be more advanced. To cause to mature. Yeah. The reason you are in that dark place right now is because God wants you to grow and to advance and to get mature in the things of God. I'm not knocking Bible school, but there are some stuff you got to go through to learn from. Mm-hmm. And so here in this dark room, God, the photographer, he takes a picture and releases you the promise. And then he places it in you, and now you're in this place called a dark room. This is a dark room. A dark room. This couldn't be a dark room. You couldn't develop good preachers up in here. Lord have mercy. You couldn't develop good prophets up in here. No. You couldn't develop good musicians up in here. You know why? Because there's too much light coming in. Good God. What am I saying? The mic too high. And so what God has to do, he has to develop some of us at our house when we're crying. Good God Almighty. He got to cut off the lights. Yeah. He can't put you up here too fast because if too much light will mess up the picture. Good God. Good Lord have mercy. So some of you are wondering why you're not being used now. It's too much light coming in right now. Yeah, there's too many people coming and your motive's not right. Yeah, Lord, I want to get up there. You know what you're saying? I want a part of the light. But the Lord is saying you need to stay in the dark room. And in the dark room, you must cut off all the lights. Yeah. You got to put black fabric up to the windows. Yeah. You just got to block all the light. Good God Almighty. And once you drop all the light, you're take the negatives, Lord have mercy. That's your insecurities, yeah. That's your fears, yeah. That's your doubt. Anything that you don't know who you are in God, that's your negatives. Your negatives got to go in the dark room. Don't come in here and tell me how God been good to you and you telling me you ain't never had a bad attitude. You telling me you ain't never flipped out. You got to take that negative in the dark room. And in the dark room, it got to go down in a solution. And in that solution, it has to be the right chemicals. What's that saying? God got to place people around you to bother you. In that solution, there's something called agitate. And when it agitates you, that's when you get to see your nasty attitude. That's when you get to see your bad temper. That's when you get to see your lust, yeah, and your disobedience and your stubbornness. You see it when people agitate you. Yeah. So here in this dark room, after he places in the negative in the solution, he has something called a developer. Mm-hmm. And good, the photographer has to grab some clothespins that we used to use back in the day. You know what clothespins is, don't it? It wasn't just dryers. We had the wood clothespins. Hold them. Your mama got so many, so don't say mama wasn't no clothespin. Them jokers, they was real cheap. That's the last lie you can tell your mama. I ain't hanging the clothes up in the clothespin. If you ain't got no clothespin, you can lay them across the line. And so the photographer, Roy, he grabs the negative with a clothespin because if he put his hands on it, he'll smear it. There are some things that God won't allow people to touch in your life Because he don't want their handprint on you while he's developing you. Oh, that's enough for you right there. There's some people that really wanted to say that's mine. Ha! Shut that up, say yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Good Lord, Hammer Roy. I know. There's some people that has passed through here, especially since Pastor Ingle left, and want to say to my people, no, the Lord ain't want their handprint on them. Yeah, God. Yeah, yeah, no, no. You want to take too much glory? God said, no, no. I need some people that'll give me glory. That'll say, if the Lord hadn't have done this. Yeah, yeah, yeah. God know that this is a special child here. God know that, anybody can't raise everybody, baby. There's some people that's insecure when you're raising somebody else, baby. But when you have the heart of the Lord, you say, Lord, I thank you for allowing me to be in the race. Yeah, yeah. I take this baton, and if I got to pass it to somebody else, I don't mind passing it to somebody else. And see, you learn those kind of lessons in the dark room, that it ain't about you. It's for the Lord's name to be glorified. I don't want to see nobody say this is the ministry of T.K. Stevenson. This is the sanctuary of hope worship ministry. The Lord has set his name here. I don't need my name on it because my name ain't got no power. I might need to change another tie next Sunday. I feel something up here. Lord have mercy. Whoa, boy, I want to go home now. This is a gifted place. 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 When this is a gifted place. And other people can see when you're gifted. And when people see you gifted, they can use you as merchandise. And they can do better because of you. Not because of their gift, but because of your gift. I remember when I went to Publix, the man said, T, we want your mind. I said, you can't have it. He died for me to be not waking up looking to go buy a crack or to get a drink. He died for that. And you think I'm going to come out here and give it away to mix bread? I know how to mix. If I don't, I know how to call error. That joke is to mix and cook stuff in the microwave fast. Yeah, he's sitting up there fooling y'all quiet self. Mm-hmm. I'm out here on the job trying to learn how to mix it. He home whipping. Ain't that what you call it? Whipping it up. You don't want to see that part of you, do you? Talking about how good he knew how to whip it up. See, I didn't know how to mix and bake back then. I used to buy mine already ready because I messed something up. But got this man down there rolling heels. Not Pierce, Florida, rolling heels. All he needed some water in the microwave. Y'all don't put that on the tape. Okay, Ray. But let me. but let me tell you what happens here. In this dungeon, after it's dipped in the developer that has the agitation, Roy, you know, you couldn't just allow the negative to sit there and think the chemicals were going to keep working. Daily, you have to keep the lights out. No light came in until it was a finished product. Mm-hmm. Daily, the photographer will have to change the solution because it loses its strength. It needed to be a consistent change. And so what the Lord said to me right there, if you want to walk in the manifestation, you're going to need to know how to be consistent behind the scenes. Are you consistent when ain't nobody watching? Are you faithful when ain't nobody watching? Are you praying? Are you giving behind the scenes? See, this here, I understand that I have my tithing envelope. I understand that I have my building envelope. That's not me giving behind the scenes. But because I believe in giving behind the scenes, you know I didn't work none last week until Friday. But I talked to the Lord behind the scenes. And when you talk to him behind the scenes, he will cause the curtains to come open and he will produce a harvest. Lord have mercy. And so here I am going down the road, and it wasn't a text message, but it was an alert message. What that was somebody sowing a seed into me. Didn't know that I was praying for a harvest. Lord have mercy. And see, good Lord have mercy. And if you learn how to practice these principles, not on stage, but even when you're not on the people stage, but knowing that God has put a platform in your life for you to sow seed behind the scenes, you'll reap harvest on the scene. Let me hurry up and go. And so here in this place, Joseph, somebody say Joseph, is praying to get out. Have you ever had a promise, waiting on it, and you're asking God, when is it coming to pass? Everybody on your feet, everybody. Let me tell you how your promise will come to pass. God allowed Pharaoh to have a problem. Did you see that? Your promise, your prayer is usually answered through somebody else having a problem. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Pharaoh couldn't interpret the dreams. That's a problem. Joseph locked up, so he got to pray. So when your promise collides with a problem, that brings forth a manifestation. I know y'all need to see it clearer. We was over there at what used to be Sanctuary of Praise. For 2 full years, I prayed. I said, Lord, we need a financial committee and a praise team where we don't have to hustle and find people to do praise and worship every Sunday. Here we are here on 5209. They're praying for a pastor. Your problem was, y'all was praying for y'all problem, and I'm praying for my problem, and guess what? God answered both of our prayers in 2 years. Y'all ain't hear me. We celebrated our second year anniversary. Y'all better see this. This is nothing but God showing this in his word. We shut down Sanctuary after 2 years. You know why? Because God had brought a promise and a problem and a prayer together. Lord have mercy. And so what happens, they said, this young boy, this Hebrew, interpreted my dreams. And Joseph hears the dream, and he interprets it for Pharaoh. No, before he interprets it, this is what happened. Pharaoh sins for him. God will have your enemy sin for you. Yeah, yeah, let me tell you how your prayers will get answered. God will have somebody in authority that has the power to sin and get you out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, just keep on praying. Keep on praying. Somebody going to get themselves in a predicament that's in authority. And God has already gifted you with what it takes to help them out. It don't trip me out no more, the cars that me and Errol wash. Y'all know it rained all week. Somebody called me Friday evening, wanted me to pray for their land in Daytona, their beach house. You could have did this free, but you just want me to wash your car? You could have texted me and say, pray for my property. You know why? Because the last time they told me and him to pray for something, they seen God work. And so what Joseph does, look at this. They send for Joseph. He gets up. He shaves himself, and he changes his raiment. And what the Lord is saying now, what you have done, good God, what you have done behind the scenes, you need to get ready, because I'm going to open the scenes now and bring you forward. That's not just for me. I'm talking to somebody in this place. God wants you to get ready now. He wants you to get ready. Yeah, you need to get ready in your mind. You need to get ready if you need to change the people you're around right now, because your labor, yeah, yeah, was not in vain. God said, I'm about to open the curtains in your life. I'm about to open heaven in your life. You got to believe, God, that your dark season is over. Your dark night, ooh, Jesus. I'm not disregarding nobody in this place, but Ronnie, Janelle right now. I heard God early say, y'all dark seasons are over. Your dark seasons are over. Your dark seasons are over. Get ready for a manifestation. Yeah. Listen to what this is how God saying it to them. And this is for us. The tears, the buckets of tears. All that did was water your promise. Yeah. If I had a tear right now, if I was you, yeah. Because the Bible say if you go in tears, you'll come back leaping in joy. It's all right to cry. And I think it was Mary J. Blige said, cry no more. I'm not going to cry no more. Yeah. You got to tell that situation, yeah. This dark night is over. Yeah. I've been developed now. I have matured now. Yeah. I'm about to advance now. Yeah. I'm looking back at you and say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I'd be still crying over this. But because God has allowed me to shake it off, good God, he has developed me. I know I'm going to look real good now because he's putting his glory on me. He's putting his favor on me. And God, oh, good God, and God's going to use you to go back and bless some of them people that tried to destroy you. Yeah, they tried to lessen you, but they couldn't lessen you because you was carrying a baby. And when you're carrying a baby, I'm talking about a God baby. I'm not talking about a biological child, but I'm talking about a God promise. And if you're carrying a promise, I don't care what they tried to do to you, it ain't coming to pass. It ain't coming to pass. The dark room is over. And Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Father, every hand of every eye closed in the building. Father, as I release this word, God, Father, I release a corporate word right now as you speak, God. The dark days are over for sanctuary. Father, Joseph had to get ready hastily. He had to get ready fast. And Father, there are some things you're about to do for us that we need to be ready, and we need to be ready fast. It's coming upon us speedily, God. Father, we thank you for the momentum and the favor of God on us, God. And Father, as I stretch forth my hand in the name of Jesus, Father, I decree, God, and declare in the name of Jesus a new season of freshness, a new season of development and advance in the lives of your people, God. Father, I decree and declare, God, every gift, God, that's in them, God, no matter how it was agitated, God, you have somebody in authority, God, to call them forth and to send for them in the name of Jesus, God. Father, I speak to managers on jobs right now, God. Father, turn hearts in the name of Jesus, God. Father, I decree and declare increase right now in the name of Jesus, God. I speak a Joseph blessing, God, over your people right now, God. The gift, the blessing, God, where the Lord shall add to. The Lord shall bless and prosper, God. So, Father, if they're not prospering, God, call them to prosper in the name of Jesus. No light in the name of Jesus. No light, God. They're coming out them dungeons right now. In the name of Jesus. They're coming out those lonely, dark places right now. In the name of Jesus, God. Bless them to the point like you blessed Joseph, God. God, where they can turn around and bless their whole family. In the name of Jesus. And Father, they'll turn around blessing their whole family, God. You're going to release forgiveness, God. Father, you allowed it, God. And God, you're shifting us forward, God. And you're shifting us forward fast. Father, you're shifting us forward, God. And you're shifting us forward fast, God. We thank you for wisdom like you gave Joseph, God. Cause that wisdom to hit this place. God, we thank you for that wisdom. Father, we thank you for helping us to see things clearer, God. God, because when we see something that's not clear, God, we can go to you with it. God, I thank you for what you just said, God. We have your ear. God said we have his ear here. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we're no more behind the scenes. You're calling us forward, God. God, we ain't got to explain to man. All we got to do is give you glory. You're about to see some great and mighty things in your life. Some things gonna blow your mind. All you got to hear, don't hear me, all you got to do is hear God. You're about to see some things come to pass in your life that you thought had died. You thought some people forgot about you. They didn't forget about you. God knew that it was going to take time to develop you with that promise. He said, get ready for it. Father, we thank you right now. God, we do bless you right now. We do honor you right now, God, because you're worthy. Father, we thank you, God, for all of those, God, that you used even in negative ways to help develop us, God. All of the dark places, God, we had to go through them. There's a healing of hurt hearts. God is healing hurt hearts in this place right now. God allowed some people to disappoint you. So they can stop telling you, I did this and I did that. The Lord is bringing you out and he's healing your heart. God don't want you bound to nobody. Father, we thank you for freedom and liberty.
Thank you for joining us today at Sanctuary of Hope Worship Ministries. We hope you enjoy the service. We look forward to seeing you next Sunday at 9:30, Landon Foundation class, following our morning worship at 10:30. Every Wednesday, we have Bible study at 7 o'clock. We would like for you to connect with us on social media, on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. God bless you. Hope to see you again next Sunday.
Invite you out to our Foundations class, which begins at 9:30 every Sunday morning from 9:30 to 10:15. The Foundations class is designed to do three things, and that is provide for everyone that walks through the doors at Sanctuary of Hope purpose, passion, and perseverance. We look to see you there.
Welcome to Ladies in Waiting, a ministry that focuses on the needs of the single woman. Come and join us as we discover how to live single God's way as we wait on Boaz. For more information, see me after service.
To you. Just want to say happy birthday to my friend and my sister and my fellow co-laborer in the ministry. Want to tell you happy birthday. I wish you many, many more. You are such a wonderful woman and I appreciate the influence that you have in my life. Thank you and happy birthday again.
Just want to wish my beautiful mother a happy birthday from me and my daughter Callie. Mama, just thank you for all the tough love and the support throughout my 26 years of my life, and I just appreciate you. And sometimes I didn't understand why I got chastised, but now I do, and I thank you for the chastising. So happy birthday, love you.
Hello, mother. Happy birthday. I really appreciate you and everything you do for us. You really go out your way to make sure that we have everything we need. And I really appreciate that and thank you for all that you've done. I love you and hope you have a good day. I would sing for you, but you ain't ready for all that yet. But all right, bruh.
Happy birthday to the most selfless lady on the planet. I thank you for just being the greatest mother ever. And I thank you for everything that you have done for all of us and always putting us above yourself. And I thank you for helping me to become the mother that I am today. I love you.
Hey, Mom, I just want to say happy birthday. Thank you for always being there for me and thank you for helping me become the man I am today. Hope you have a great birthday and many years to come. Love you very much.
I love you. I hope you enjoy your day. Pray you get to see many more.
Happy birthday, Miss Stevenson. Happy birthday, Miss Stevenson. Hope you have a wonderful day.
Happy birthday.